what's going on?
How's it? And welcome to another episode of Ride Bikes Be Happy, brought to you from the basement. Today we're going to talk a little bit more about the GoPro Hero 9 and the fact that it's bad, but it's not so bad. And it's good? Well, really good, but not really, really good. But first, here's the intro. I think one of the worst things about the GoPro is that we just keep buying them because they're so good at what we buy them for. But the reality is they have all these stupid little idiosyncrasies that we kind of overlook because they're so good at doing what we buy them for. And we just kind of accept the having to pull the battery out to unfreeze it and things like that. Or do we? So what's good? Well, remember, I've just upgraded from a GoPro Hero 5 Black to a Hero 9 Black. It's chalk and cheese, night and day, Jekyll and Hyde, Charles and Diana. You get the point. The obviously huge thing with the GoPro Hero 9 is that it does 5K, and 5K is amazing. And then it's got video stabilization that's off the charts. It is so good, it's crazy. It's literally a gimbal killer. And especially if you have the lens mod. And then there's the audio. The audio is off the hook. I mean, I'm recording now with the on-camera media mod mic. That's loads of little trees down all over the place. Love this section here though. I don't know why, it reminds me of home, I think. Crazy good. I don't even have a lapel mic on me, which I had to use with my Hero 5. So compared to its predecessors, it's a huge leap forward, even from the Hero 8. Because let's face it, I was still running a Hero 5 because the Hero 8 just wasn't that good of an upgrade, but the Hero 9 is excellent. So I really wanted this camera for two main reasons. Well, three. The first one was the HyperSmooth 3.0. I mean, it's a gimbal killer. I'll be honest though, I'll probably still use my GoPro Hero 5 with the Fiyutech gimbal for certain shots because it just has a different kind of feel. So for certain shots, it's just gonna give you something different, and yeah, we don't wanna be too boring, eh? Secondly, I wanted to use the media mod with the shotgun mic built into it for these kind of shots. And then I also wanted the ease of being able to plug a lavalier mic into it. For these kind of shots. So it's basically two in one. I've got a media mod with a shotgun mic attached to it. I can use it for vlogging kind of things and that sort of stuff. I can also use it on the bike where I have the stability of the lens and the media mod giving me really good audio, so I can basically record audio and go to video all at the same time while on the bike. And then the third thing that's really cool is a little forward facing screen. So I can frame my shots, I can make sure that I'm in shot, I can make sure a lot of things are happening when I'm basically in front of the camera, and that's really cool. And then, and I have to be honest here, it's just so good at all of the video stuff. 5K, 4K, way more frames per second than I can even think of right now. Slow motion, time warp, which is way more fun than I thought it would be. All of these things the Hero 9 is just so good at that it's like it's another level. And then there is the rad new interface. A lot of people that seem to be complaining about it, like scrolling through the menu is slower than on their iPhone. Obviously it's slower than on their iPhone. The iPhone is basically designed to have a touchscreen. It's the main reason why we bought smartphones. This is a camera with a really good touchscreen on the back of it. Light years ahead of the Hero 5, light years ahead of even the Hero 7. I didn't have a Hero 8, so I can't tell you whether it was light years ahead of that, but it's really, really good. I can't explain to you how cool it is to be able to like just touch on the screen, select the video mode I'm looking for, edit that video mode if I need to, change little things like which mic has been used, what audio levels to be using, which lens mod is, or if the lens mod is on or off, things like that. That stuff is so quick to adjust now that I don't even have to use my smartphone connected to my camera to do those kind of adjustments because you can just do them on the camera now way easier. So that's great. So what's the bad? These are the things that drive me crazy. is really bad, as far as I'm concerned. There are two, maybe three things that really annoy me about GoPros. The one, there's that ever-present danger that you could be recording something, you push the record stop button, and nothing happens. And then you kind of gamble with, is that little piece of footage, or that large piece of footage, saved in the camera? Because invariably, your camera's frozen, and you're gonna have to pull out the battery to reset it. And once you pull out the battery, it's probably not gonna save that video. And then the other bad thing for me, the thing that really gets on me, is GoPro's app. Best action camera in the world, worst app in the world. Yes, they've done a new update, they've now changed the name of the app to Quick. Quick is, the app isn't fast. It's actually really slow. I'm running an iPhone XS, so 3 generation old iPhone, pretty modern. It doesn't work well on that. On my iPad Pro, same thing. It's not very quick. It's pretty sluggish. It's pretty dodgy user interface. It, all in all, is not really great. For me, the problem with the Hero 9 so far has really been the forward-facing screen. The camera will boot up, and the forward-facing screen will turn on, but not boot up. So you won't get an image on the screen. It'll just be like backlit in a way. That is flippin' annoying. At the end of the day, it was one of the top three reasons why I bought the camera, and the forward-facing screen sometimes just doesn't turn on. So I don't know what's happening with the frame, but I'm also not aware of any of the other information that I need to know, how long I've been recording for, those sort of things that appear on the front screen. Hopefully there's a firmware update and that fixes that problem. And then of course the usual, you have to remove the battery freeze moment, which is something you kind of get used to with the GoPro. It's only happened twice since I've been using the Hero 9 system, the older camera and now this one, but it's a problem when you have the media mod on, because to get the battery out, you have to take the media mod off. And that's a pain in the ass. And yes, although I just sang the praises of the new touch screen, it is a little sluggish. It's not as big of a problem as people are making it out to be, because at the end of the day, like I said, it's not an iPhone, it's a GoPro. The screen can be a little sluggish, especially when you're deep in the menus and you're trying to go backwards. That can be a bit of a pain. It's not the end of the world. At the end of the day, like I say, it's not an iPhone, it's a camera. So just to explain, in the last video, I said that somebody had given me a GoPro Hero 9. They did, and they took it back. So I had to get myself a new one because I couldn't really live without it. Normally one does these unboxing videos at the beginning of a video, but you know, why be normal? After digging out a bunch of stuff and selling it on eBay, I went the whole hog. I got the Hero 9 Black, the lens mod, the media mod, the battery charger with a spare battery, couple of extra spare batteries, and of course the deal came with a 64 gig memory card. And it's back on the pedal. And what better way to show you how cool it all works than by taking it all out on the trail and testing it. And then this gets really gnarly. I could crash at the bottom here, let's have a look. I'll try not to. I'm gonna gear up to really easy gear, drop the saddle all the way in, and then try to hold my line with all the leaves at the bottom here. And it basically goes off camera in the G-up. There's a root there, tree to miss, and then up here and whew,